Hello, good afternoon. I went upstairs looking for specimens today, as I do every other day. Happens to be plant day. So the job of me, my job on plant day, is to try to make the cells of the plants visible. It's kind of a task that I assigned myself. And so I went upstairs and I look around, and there are some really interesting plants with very tempting to take samples of them, but I'm a little hesitant now because I have in the past damaged some house plants, and I don't want to do that again, so I'm very careful what I pick. Normally I try to find something that's already broken or something like that, but I didn't find anything. I kept looking for something tempting, and I couldn't find anything. Finally, I went into the kitchen, and there on the floor near the garbage receptacle is a pumpkin, which looked pretty intact, but I think it probably was left over from Halloween, and I think it was destined to be thrown out, at least I hope so. And I figured I would take a sample of the skin of the pumpkin and see if I could see the cells of the pumpkin skin, and I took my sharp knife and I cut a little piece off the back of the pumpkin so that my friend wouldn't think I was stealing the pumpkin to make a sample. Anyway, I took it downstairs and I start working on it. Now, normally, what I do with these samples is I cut a little piece off and I start scraping it with my X-Acto knife, so that scrape layers of cells off, so that I can make it reasonably translucent, so light passes through it, and I can see the cell walls, which is what you have to do with microscopes. It took me a while. The skin was very leathery, very and rigid because of the age, and it took a while for me to scrape it down to the point where it was useful. And in the process also, I scraped unevenly, so that there were places where the vision was pretty good and other places where it was less good, and I had to change my parameters on the microscope and focus, refocus for different distances. So there were times when I finally get decent pictures of the cells. In fact, they're quite vivid. And because of the differences in depth of the cell structures, the fact that I peeled off more layers in some places than others, it sometimes looked like the sun is passing through it. It reminded me of those medieval paintings of the clouds of heaven. Anyways, I think you'll find that interesting because gradually the shape of the cells, the natural shape of the cells, becomes more and more vivid. Take a look.